It's all the intangibles that make such a difference. It's that feeling of having unconditional acceptance. And most people assume we get that in our homes, in our families, in our birth family, but not, that is not true all the time. And so it's the people that we associate with, that we share chicken soup with, that we share a meal with, that we talk to on the phone, that we laugh with. They become our family, and they become the ones that give us that unconditional love. And that's what we want to do for the people that we have here at the cafe, at the clinic, at Casa Madre, that there's some place in the world where they know that people care about them, that have accepted them unconditionally, because they accept us with all our faults too.
In December 1992, four Ursuline sisters, sitting around a Christmas tree, asked each other where Jesus would be ministering today. They all had experiences where people with HIV had been treated badly, and they decided to look into what services were available for people living with HIV in our community.
So they began to attend a local support group and then started their own prayer support group for people with HIV and their caregivers. Then came Angela's Place, a pantry of household goods and toiletries collected by local churches and civic groups.
And that went on for a long time, and we kept saying, is there anything else we can do for you? One of the volunteers said, you know, we really need to start feeding people too.
Our cafe that we have once a month, Guardian Angel Cafe, it's like a big support group for people who have no one and for people who have family.
It's a place that people with HIV/AIDS can go and meet with people sharing the same likeness.
They know somebody really cares.
They can come and they can feel at home.
I think that's a big need because a lot of them are isolated.
The cafe has become a place of community for people.
I think this is a great place for people to come together and to feel accepted.
And it's a chance for them to get together and really be in a safe place.
Sometimes they can discuss their problems with each other because they have the same problems.
It is like a family.
People started bringing their kids. And as we began to spend more time with the kids, we realized that they really had a lot of needs. We call it Casa Madre. It's a triplex on the south side of Youngstown, and it's a home. We left it as a home.
I just think it gives the kids, you know, that comfort and provides that family.
We try to do one-on-one tutoring so that they have a mentor.
And we have the kids there 3 nights a week for dinner and tutoring, and during the summer for a summer camp program.
It may be the only time they're getting one-on-one attention at all during the day.
Due to their tutoring program, they've helped my daughter succeed. She has been with the Casa Madre Children's Program since it started.
It's nice to be a part to that extent of their life and their progress.
The children have formed a community at the house. They love coming to the house.
So we had the children's program, and somebody came to us from Northside Hospital, Dr. John Van Glarchik, and then at the time one of the directors, and said that they were closing the HIV clinic at Todd Children's Hospital. It was primarily a pediatric clinic, and could we do anything about it? There was very little HIV healthcare in Youngstown.
Obviously, we need something.
People would not probably travel to Pittsburgh.
There's a lot of people from Youngstown that have no way to get to those clinics. When we came in and started doing what we do, we got more people in care.
It's a free clinic. If you don't have insurance, you can get help. Someone's there to counsel you. Someone's there to inform you.
When we started the clinic, that was another way to show people that we respected them, is they have a safe place now to come for health care.
I don't think the stigma has gotten any better for HIV.
I don't either. It's still there, still prevalent.
It's really awful. I think the hospitals have gotten better at taking care of the patients because they're not as afraid of them. The more knowledge they have, the better off they are, but the stigma is still there.
Stigma is probably just as deadly as the disease itself.
Mm-hmm.
Just because people make their medical choices based on the stigma. So they would rather choose to die and not take care of themselves than to have to acknowledge to somebody else that they have it.
Mm-hmm.
HIV shows no discrimination. It can affect anyone and everyone.
Regardless of their gender or their sexuality.
No matter how they got the disease, how sick they are,
right.
What their family thinks, we love them and we are so happy to take care of them. We're so happy that they found us.
I think we met a definite need that was out there for human beings.
One of the first patients I took care of at St. East said to me, the worst thing about this disease is nobody wants to touch you and nobody wants to hug you. From that point on, I hug.
One of the songs that I have always liked that kept cropping up was Barbara Streisand's People Who Need People Are the Luckiest People in the World. And that seems to sort of typify what we've been about.
I can't say enough because they have been there through thick and thin for myself, my family, and I've seen how they've reached out and helped others.
It's just a nice place to be, to give back.
And I love what I do. Every day I can't wait to go to work because it's just, every day is different. I meet new people, I touch other people's lives. They touch mine. They've given me so much more than what I can ever give to them, you know.
They let you in and it's very easy to connect with the kids. It's very easy to get to know them and, to forge these relationships. And that's really what, I think is important.
Once you start working at the clinic and you see the relationships with the patients and you see the changes you make in their life, it just drives you to want to do more.
Myself, I feel that God has really blessed me. I have my health and a lot of friends, and my giving back a little bit every month makes me feel really good that I can do that.
Nothing that we have done compares to what we have gotten back from people.
I want to leave my footprints on the sands of time. No, there was something that meant something that I left behind. When I leave this world, I'll leave no regrets. Leave something to remember so they won't forget I was here.
In this anniversary year, we are honoring 20 years in ministry, honoring those who've died, those who live with HIV/AIDS, those who support our ministry, and those who fight for an end to HIV. Two decades on, more people are living with HIV than dying of AIDS. But HIV is still very much with us, and so our work continues. Food, advocacy, mentoring, healthcare, tutoring, support. For our part, we hope for the day when we are no longer needed, because HIV is just another chapter in a history book. Until then, we will continue to do the work of caring for those with HIV and their families in our community. And we thank you for joining us in that work.